Hello and welcome to you all to the Carlin Students Union Sports Wars 2015. Alright, so just before I start, I read this speech to my mum over the phone, and she told me I counted 76 swear words, and were you actually supposed to cry at the end? So I apologise for this. I'm very, very passionate about this university. So start off then. We're here to celebrate all the fabulous achievements of the University of Gloucestershire Sport this year. And thank you, all of you, for your amazing commitment for throughout your first, second, third, some of you fourth years. Let go, guys. Someone once told me that if you're happy in a relationship, you put on a bit of a relationship weight. So therefore, you can see that this year I've been pretty happy with my relationship with my sports officer position, because if I breathe out, all my buttons are going to explode on all these guys. I've put on about a stone, I reckon. So once again, we've proved to the rest of the UK that the Team Gloss is by far to be a force to be reckoned with. We've always punched well above our weight as an institution, and we're still growing in strength. This year, beating the likes of Oxford, Bath, Exeter in various competitions, and UOG is sitting above some of the bigger and better funded institutions in Bucks rankings. We're currently placed at 38th in the national tables, which is two positions above last year. Sorry, James. So let's give us all a round of applause for our amazing achievement, guys. So this year our sports membership has finally broken the 1,000 barrier. We're up to 1,200 and we're only at 900 last year. So that's an amazing thing. And that definitely explains all our successes this year. So I just thought I'd name a couple of big moments this year, because this is quite a long speech, I apologise. Naked Calendar saw us all lose our clothes to dress up in the style of films this year. We raised over £700 for Carly Taylor and the MyX charity, which is a brilliant and really good laugh. The funniest memory for me was the netball team, who seemed to forget they had to change in the room. And they walked from one end of the uni down to the other in a pair of pants, cupping their chests in hand. Thank God we didn't have a cardiac rehab session on, all those guys had keeled over. This is a real sore one for me, varsity. It's the biggest one we've ever done, and thanks to all you guys who helped pull it off. It killed me to lose. But unfortunately, in 10 years, they had to at least win it once, didn't they? But the support was absolutely fantastic, and I know Lauren will help us bring that trophy back next year, so well done for that, guys. So I thought a bit of a change of tradition, instead of talking about all the amazing things this year and blabbing on, I wanted to talk about a bit about the teams, so please indulge me, there's a lot of you. American football. Finished their season raising awareness for underlying heart conditions in a tribute to a player who sadly passed away this year. They should be very, very proud of themselves for putting on an amazing spectacle for us all. So well done, guys. Yeah, well done, Tom Fletcher. Yeah. Athletics, led this year by Liam Sanford and Pete Richmond, absolutely amazing. They've progressed twofold, creating local partners, increasing their marketing presence, and smashing records and PBs left, right, and centre. So well done, guys. Badminton had a tricky year rebuilding the club, but they came together and performed really, really well at varsity. really, getting really close with the result, but considering on paper Worcester were a superior opposition, they absolutely smashed it. So well done, guys. Basketball women's had a cracking start to the year, winning most improved club. Unfortunately, they struggled with numbers in the latter half of the year, but they did really, really well, and they've done a commendable effort throughout the rest of the year. So well done, guys. Men's basketball can't be here tonight, unfortunately, but they had probably their best year in memory, coming second in their Bucks League. Unfortunately, they couldn't overcome the mighty Worcester, but they kept them under 100, and that was their main aim, apparently, so they did a cracking job there. Ballbriders really upped the ante this year, and have built their club up properly into the sports community, so it's really good to have you guys properly involved with us this year. Cheer, as always. Absolutely incredible. Coming out with masses of trophies, they're running out of space for them all. Brilliant fundraising this year to keep their club afloat, and expertly run by Ellie Carter at the helm. Cricket, I don't know where to start with you guys. You've been a massive surprise to us this year. The lads have had the best year that cricket have ever had at UOG. Smashing Worcester in the first varsity. And rinsing through the Bucks leagues, and they had a shot of winning it this week, and they've just confirmed that they have actually won their league. So well done, guys. Go Rainy on Dance. Dance, properly added to the sports ranks this year, have come in with a bang. They've held one of the best fundraisers we've ever seen with Strictly Come Dancing. Liam Sanford and Josh Acton sharing their prowess there. And in my opinion, and everyone else here's opinion, they were completely robbed at varsity. Their judging was horrendous. There we go. A question. Added an extra team this year, have an incredible structure to build on for next year. An ace work this year, guys. Well done, Lauren, for her terrific work this year. Football men's. Two of you managed to get along tonight. Well done. They really struggled this year. However, there are a few cracking performances, and they're also building stage for next year. Bounced back well after a frustrating year last year, and they managed to keep themselves afloat. So well done, guys. Women's football. Now, they had the years of ups and downs. Although the first ended up near the bottom of the table, they fought back to avoid relegation in brilliant fashion. And Women's Twos won their Conference Cup final this year. So well done, girls. A really amazing effort. Futsal. Women had an amazing year again, winning their league. And the men's had the ups and downs and unfortunately missed out of varsity, which is supposed to be our clincher, so we better come back and win that one next year. Golf. New club this year. It's great to see them developing, and exciting to see what they're going to do next year. I hope you're all enjoying desserts, by the way. Mine's sitting waiting for me. Hockey. Men's hockey started a tad negatively, they won't mind me saying. But they've worked really, really hard to come back, and credit to the guys. They've got better week in, week out. They've actually run the club really well. So well done, guys. Kendo. Run by everyone's favourite, Linda Lee. They've had a really great year. They've engaged with the sporting community really well, doing taster sessions, running a national competition, and they've grown from strength to strength. So well done, girls and guys. Rowing. They've grown exponentially this year. Every time they come to my office, there's about another 10 of them at Rock Up. It's been absolutely amazing working with you guys. First varsity ever, it was amazing. Yeah, you may have come last, but you absolutely smashed it. It never gave up for a second, it was incredible. They got a few medals to boot, and a really successful year. Rugby league. Yeah! They had a bit of an unfortunate year with both teams just missing out on the top spots, but they really, really had a hard-fought season. Jack Binks has worked tirelessly this year to get more money back into the club, and he's an absolute credit to you guys. Rugby Union. We'll start with women's. They've been pretty average this year, to be honest, haven't they? I won't go into too much detail because we're talking about it a bit later on, but it's been an unbelievable season, to say the least, so well done, girls. Right, we're getting there through teams now. The men's rugby team. It's more of in the room than anyone else, that's this year. They also tragically lost one of their members and a dear friend last year. I won't go into too much detail about it, as I'll start crying, and I could probably talk about him for hours. And I won't ruin Jeff's speech later on. However, they did an incredible memorial match for this man, and also seemed to psych him up for the rest of their season. Yeah, okay, we'll give Arthur a bit of a round of applause. He might deserve that at least. However, this tragic loss actually did seem to psych him up for the season. They thrashed out all years, getting themselves back into the league that they were relegated from. Also reaching the Conference Cup final and just missing out to Hartbury, but it's an amazing season for the club, so well done, guys. Swimming and water polo. They had a really, really busy year, competing at Bucks Nationals, Bucks water polo competitions, scooping up loads of swimming points through Dan Bennett, who's performed brilliantly this year, and also putting on an amazing Splash the Titans fundraiser. So well done, guys. Tennis. They seem to have won their, like, 1 millionth varsity. They never seem to lose any points. Absolutely amazing work, you guys. And we definitely want to give the girls a shot next year so we can smash Worcester in two tennis varsities. Trampolining. Had a very, very tense time at varsity with what felt like the closest competition ever, but they absolutely smashed it, as just as they have done all year, getting involved with everything under excellent supervision by the wonderful Jenny Smith. Women's volleyball. That was a bit shrill. Women had a cracking year, winning the Bucks League this year and reaching the Cup Conference Finals. Really awesome work this year, girls. Absolute credit to us. And last but not least, the men's volleyball team. Seeing as they started the year with only three players and we were looking to potentially didn't know what to do with these guys, the club's now thriving. Well done, Paolo, and I'm sure James will take it on leaps and bounds next year. Right, so that's all the teams done. Just indulge me again for another little story, I'm afraid. So, oh, did I forget someone? All right. Yeah, no, netball's had an amazing season this season. Unfortunately, missed out of varsity, and it was a real shame. But they fought right away through. They fought right through the end. And I missed women's hockey, so I don't know. I'm so sorry. Women's hockey have been fantastically led this year. They're going to take it on next year with Emily Court and everyone else at the helm. And I'm going to be beaten up in the bar later. I'm really, really sorry. One job, right? Right, okay then, this is sort of the main bit of my speech. I'm really sorry, I will try and hurry through this. So, blue and blue spirit. This is one thing that we've quoted all year. Third and fourth years among you, you know what this is. For freshers and second years, I hope you're beginning to understand this. I had a little think the other day, and I tried to personify this term. We band about regularly, but we don't seem to know how to justify it. I thought to myself, is this a thing we can touch? Is it a thing we can feel? Or is it just justification of our actions? I couldn't come up with an answer, but it reminded me of a special day. One day that sprang to mind was the 12th of January. Myself and Lane were frantically rushing around the office like every Wednesday, trying to sort out the teams going out that day, when Liv Kennaway came into my office, the basketball CC, saying unfortunately she only had 5 players for that day and the game was at 1 p.m. We had about an hour to try and sort it out. She wasn't disheartened at all. She seemed fully prepared to play with the amount of players that she had. But however, we sat down, we messaged around trying to find some extra players for them. By 12:55, we had SU sabbaticals with Fenno. We had netballers, we had badminton players, all lined up to play for them. People who had games later on or work to be done, they all turned up just to help out one of our fellow UOG sports teams. The referees then sprang it on us that the additional players needed numbered kit. And I thought, oh sugar. The game then couldn't play on, so we rummaged around every room and cupboard and wrangled some old white football kit, which looked ridiculous. But they all chucked it on, some of it was too big for them. But they absolutely played their hearts out. The girls got on there and smashed it. They ended up losing 65-52, which was in no way a reflection about the sheer amount of passion that the effort the girls put in just to help out Liv and the girls. Later that day was the women's rugby game at the Prince of Wales Stadium. This game was the decider to who wins the group to go through the quarterfinals. So after much promotion from Andy, myself and the team, the stands were absolutely packed. We had over 400 people sitting in the Chile Stadium. During this game, the girls went down to 10-0 and all looked lost, with all our girls' heads going down. But the mighty UOG crowd fired up and were roaring their chants away in the second half of the game. This act caused every one of our UOG's girls to fill with confidence. They kept their fighting their way through the Cardiff defences until they secured their vital 2-point lead. The roar of the crowd of the final whistle was deafening, with beaming smiles permanent on everyone's faces for the rest of the evening. These two acts show how amazing and dedicated our students are to each other. No matter what club you're from, if you fall under the same gloss banner, ever proud and passionate to celebrate our successes, commiserate our losses, and help in our growth and development. It makes me proud to wear the badge on my chest. And it will be forever in my heart. I hope you will inspire the next generation of freshers to feel the same passion and carry this on for the next few years. This has been without doubt the best year of my life. I've been through every emotion possible, and honestly, I've not got my head around leaving or giving up trying to progress UOG sport. So Mr. Stephen Marsden, if Andy Pitchford ever decides to move on from here, my Director of Sport application is ready for you. Right, so on to tonight then. The awards. Myself, Elaine, Larea sat down and considered all of the awards against various guidelines. We also took votes from the club captains this year to try and make it a bit of a fairer process. So this is trying to make it as fair a decision as possible. We're here to celebrate your amazing successes and all of you guys. And it is everything about you. So I'm going to stop babbling on and crack on with these awards. So just another side note. You can take the trophies to your table and have pictures of them afterwards, but we need them all back at the end, please. They're all tagged. Right then, so without further ado, I'm going to invite next year's sports officer, Lauren Shenoweth, to the stage.
You can't see at all up here, but it's a bit blurry. I'm here on behalf of FaZe this year to award the winning men's and women's teams for Tough 10. £40 will go towards their budget or the bar, if they'd rather. I'd like to thank all the SU teams who were involved in Tough 10 this year. We had the most amount of entries we've had in the previous history, so that's amazing. A big round of applause to yourselves. The teams competed in over 10 tough activities, which then whittled down to 3 men's finalists and 2 women's finalists. So, without further ado, I'd like to announce the winners. So can we have the first drum roll this evening, please? To invite Alex Burnett from men's rowing and Ellie Carter from cheerleading to come and collect your awards. And we're gonna let it burn.
Guys, I would like to move on to the next award for Marketing Officer of the Year, and I'd like to invite the Chief Executive of the Students' Union, John Abel, to present this, please.
As social media has grown exponentially in recent years, we felt that this year was the time to introduce the role of marketing officer to all committees. The person in charge of each club's promotional materials on their SU mini site, Twitter, Facebook, the sports homepage, and those awesome videos you saw at the start tonight. If used effectively, these are useful tools to communicate information about a club to current and potential members. This year, clubs have thought outside the box with their communications and sports updates, causing the marketing to be much more effective than previously. There has been a growing presence of sports communication and news within the university media and local papers. It must be credited to the fantastic work from these marketing officers. This year's club nominations for Marketing Officer of the Year are Athletics, Badminton, Cheerleading, Equestrian, Rowing, Women's Rugby, and the Tramps. And the winner is... Athletics.
So next up, to present the award for the most improved team of the year, I'd like to invite our SU subs, Catherine and Louise, to the stage, please.
Is a fantastic achievement. It shows the commitment and sacrifice made from not just your captain, not just your committee, but from top to bottom throughout your team. It's a wonderful accolade, and for the winner, it's a credit to all the hard work that has been put in during games and behind the scenes. Here are your nominees. Cricket. Dance. Equestrian.
Golf.
Kendo.
Rowing.
Rugby league.
And men's hockey.
This year has seen many new teams add to our ranks. These have strengthened our athletic prowess as a university and added a great deal more diversity. This club has moved from strength to strength throughout the year and hit all targets set for them. They also put out an incredible varsity performance, of which they should have won. This year's most improved club of the year are
So the next award tonight is the Global Athlete Award, and we're going to hand over to Mr. Nick Roberts, who started Global Athletes this year.
The Global Athletes Award is a new award presented by the Students' Union. This award recognises the achievements of UOG sports teams for their work off the pitch, making a positive impact on their community and the environment. The opportunity for sport to deliver change is beginning to recognise internationally, and I'm proud to say that UOG is leading the way in this sector. The Global Athletes Award is a great success at UOG, so keep an eye out for its national expansion next year with more prizes and more opportunities to win and make a difference. However, for this year, it is my pleasure to announce the 2015 Global Athletes Award nominees, and they are board riders, kendo, trampolining, cheer, and women's volleyball. And the winner of the award this year, and £750 for their club account, is trampolining.
Well done, girls, and thank you very much, Nick. Okay, so it's me up to do the next one. So we have the Julia Hester Award for dedication to badminton. This award is in memory of Julia Hester, whose life was tragically cut short. Julia was a dedicated member of the University Badminton Club, and this award is given out for commitment, enthusiasm to badminton on and off the court. The club had a lot to live up to after a huge amount of success last year, and this person has been a key cog within the organisation of the club and has managed to reignite a whole new level of fun and enthusiasm after losing a huge amount of players and figureheads last year. This year's winner has shown an incredible commitment to the badminton club without expecting anything in return. This year's winner Beth Woodward. Something's Okay, so next I'd like to invite everyone's favourite lecturer and all-star legend, Mr. Mark Jeffries, to the stage.
Evening all. For the last 6 or 7 years, we've given the Memorial Award for Chris Ball and John Haldane, who were both members of the rugby club and both tragically died while they were at uni. This year, it's with great sadness, but also with great pride, that we add Arthur Mason's name to the trophy. Arthur was a big part of the club, but the club was a big part of Arthur. And the communication that we've had with his family during the tragic time and ever since, through the Memorial Award, the club dinner, etc., has just shown how being part of a club in a sport at University of Gloucestershire is meant to Arthur and it meant to his family as well. So it is with great pride that I hand this out tonight. The trophy is given out to the Clubman of the Year, and the Clubman of the Year is somebody who dedicates obviously a lot of time to the club to develop it in lots of different ways. This isn't given out to the most outstanding player, but it's given out to the most outstanding clubman. I think this year it goes to somebody who's done both. This person came to the university 4 years ago as a very tall, lanky streak of nothing. He'd never played county rugby, but has worked tremendously hard both off the pitch and on the pitch, and has been rewarded over the last couple of years, last year representing England students, and this year both being awarded a full-time contract with Gloucester, but actually taking up a contract with England Sevens. And I'm glad that he's just returned from Moscow, where they were on the weekend, and he's here to collect his prize. So the winner of the Memorial Rugby Union Clubman of the Year is Rory Mack.
Well done, Rory, and thank you, Mark. So next up, I would like to invite ex-Sabbatical Officer and current Social Enterprise Coordinator, Silas Miller, to present the Russ Simmons Memorial Award.
This year, we'll be giving out this award in remembrance of Russell Simmons, who tragically took his own life 2 years ago. At the University of Gloucestershire, we are an extremely tight-knit community, and when someone passes away, it sadly affects us all on many levels. Russ was someone who embodied blue and blue spirit, even as a fresher, and was known for his vibrant personality and genuine nature. Woo! He was an inspiration to many and is very sadly missed by his friends and our community. This award is going to a person who echoes Russ's mannerisms and passion for his club. He will be a fantastic addition to the Students' Union next year and will lead the Students' Union as well as he has led his club this year. I'm very pleased to announce that this year's winner is Liam Sanford.
Love is a blaze, I saw flames from the side of the stage, and the fire brigade comes in a couple of days. Until then, we got nothing to say and nothing to know, but something to drink and maybe something to smoke. Let it go until our roads are changed, singing we found love.
Well done, Liam, and thank you, Silas. So this comes down to me to present the performance of the year. There have been some breathtaking performances from Team Gloss throughout this year. It's been inspirational to watch, hear about the mighty victories, and we've clinched to the side of our seat sometimes, and where we've just been edging away from just winning and losing in the last few seconds of the game. So your Sports Performance of the Year nominees are cricket for their win in Worcester, the Women's Football Seconds, the Conference Cup winners, Men's Football First for their cup win on penalties against Hartbury, Women's Hockey with their Varsity win, Men's Rugby Union First Cup semi-final win in extra time, and the Women's Rugby Union Championship win over Cardiff Met. The winner is slide. Bummer. Right. This was ridiculously hard to decide. You already know it is now. With so many truly epic performances, we took into consideration suggestions from club captains, which is a significant factor in this case, and we took in the significance of the win. But your performance of the year goes to men's cricket for their Varsity win. My bad on that one. I'll try and build a bit more suspense next time. So the awards for sporting excellence. I would like to invite our international colleague, Laurea Sorobi, to the stage to present his awards, please.
Say I'm much more calm now that he's actually messed it up in the previous one, and saying this award is given to one male and one female that have given the best showcase of what this university has to offer with regards to performance. The nominations are for the male athlete or performance excellence of the year. And the female one. So Dan Bennett for swimming, James Gayan, Rugby Union League, Joby Wilson, karate, Rory McConaghy, Rugby Union. For the female ones, Bianca Blackman, women's rugby, Linda Lee, kendo.
Yeah.
There you go. Sarah Nicholas, Rugby Union. Nicole Talbot, weightlifting. Jess Elbeck, Rugby, Women's Rugby. The male award winner is someone that has been working extremely hard for his team since arriving at university. He not only performs at an extremely high level, week in, week out, but also conducts himself in an inspiring manner for the rest of his club, and in fact, for the whole university. He's modest beyond measure, and he's always looking to improve his game, putting in hours in training. He's now competing at the most elite international level, but still comes back to pass on his knowledge and aid the coaches and the players in his club. The female award winner is someone that all of the sports clubs are very fond of. Her incredibly genuine nature and huge amount of hard work are truly assets of this university. She's possibly one of the most respectful people that we've ever met, and that has gained her a huge amount of respect from all of us. It's fantastic to see such a high level of athletic performance accompanied by such an inspirational attitude. She has not only represented Great Britain, but has done an outstanding job with the growth of the community regarding her club. Please join me and give me a huge round of applause for Rory McKennagy and Linda Lee.
Can't touch this. Look, man, can't touch this. You better get hyped, boy, because you know you can't touch this. Ring the bell, school's back in. Break it down. You can't touch this. Can't touch this.
Right, so it's back to me again. I've elected myself to present this award as it's one that's close to my heart as a previous winner. As I mentioned earlier, this university has some truly exceptional people within the realms of competitive sport. However, this award is given to a member of the club that has gone above and beyond many club members that have done a fantastic job throughout the year, and there are so many of you that I'd like to recognise. But these nominees are all members that have been a true asset in their club this year. These nominees are Alex Burnett, rowing. Chloe Bryant, swimming and water polo. Jenny Smith, trampolining. Kel Monstad, lacrosse. And Lauren Grunberg, equestrian. This year's winner is someone that has worked exceptionally hard for their team and never seems to stop. They have helped to completely transform and revolutionise their club, double its membership, and make its environment that extra bit special for its members. Without doubt, your club member of the year 2015 is Alex Burnett. Okay, we're flying through these now. So next up, a little bit of a break from proceedings, I'd like to invite our SABs and Mr. Andy Pitchford to the stage to hand over our colours this year. Okay, so this is by far the longest time of the night. We'll try and keep this quick. So these guys are going to read out your colours for each team. Myself and Andy are going to present them over the far side. We'll invite everyone on stage at a time from the club. We'll take a picture to save a bit of time, okay? So, club colours are the highest recognition for your university sport, and only those who have been truly dedicated to the club will receive this prestigious award. In order to gain colours, a certain criteria must be met, which involves the person giving their time, effort, in order to help run their club successfully. These have been submitted by club captains and verified by myself and the sports committee. If you've received full or half colours, please make your way to the stage when prompted to receive your colours patch and certificate for such an achievement. Okay, so I'm going to hand over to Fenno, Kesh and Catherine, who are going to read out for each team.
Okay, it'll be on the screen, so you have to read out the screen.
Yeah. So, awarding half colours for American football. Got Amantel Yuan Amanento, Tom Fletcher and Dan Gilding. Awarded full colours. Ross Flatterley, Russell Wadey and Stephen Hartman.
And Alex Nicholas. Full colours, Pete Richmond and Liam Sanford.
Let me go. That sky. this is gonna take a bit of getting used to, but I know what's right for you. Let me go.
For board riders, Harm Cullors, Sally Latham, and Tasman Chilcott, well done.
Safe. When tears aren't big.
Women's football, Half Colours, Raffaella.
You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
The beat of the hero, breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride.
Your name,
cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the hall of fame.
Yeah. And the world,
if you gave me a chance, I would take it. It's a shot in the dark, but I'll make it. Knowing the little hope, you can't shame me when I am with you. There's no place I'd rather be.
Full colours go to Emily Carter Davis, Lauren Osgood, and Jess Marie Fisher.
Hear me, one good reason why I should never make a change. Baby, if you want me, then all of this will go away. Hear me, one good reason why I should never make a change. Starts again. Starts again. The love kick starts again. Starts again.
It's the same old you, the same old me. You get bored and I get cold feet. Get high, get wondering eyes. Forget I've never ever had it so sweet. I realize what I've got when I'm out of town. Cause deep down you're my girl in the golden crown. My princess and I don't wanna let you down. No, I don't wanna let you down. Down, 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 down.
You want me to come over?
I got an excuse. Baby Scowen, Josh Bull, Sarah Hudge, and Kel Monstad.
Dalton, Hannah Howells, Sophie Gray.
Go, you're gonna leave him.
Foster. I'm really sorry. Teyuka Osaki, Jack Phillips, Gavin Laycock, Joe Sagu, and Sam Costley. Four colours: Callum Stuckey, Ashley Ilston, Ben Cave, and Ross Cook.
Joel Gill, four colours goes to Jack Binks and Joshua Shackleton. I forgot to add this one in here. But we've got one last colour, and that's for sports therapy. These members should be separately recognised as members of university that have often given up their time, their own opportunity to play sport, in order to provide superb care and treatment for all sports teams. Please show your appreciation for this person who has given up her own time to support her club from the sidelines this year. Receiving full colours this year is Sian Renwick.
Can't touch this. Look, man, can't touch this. You better get a hype, boy, because you know you can't touch this. Ring the bell, school's back in. Break it down.
Right then, so we move on to the university caps. I'd like to invite Phil Llewellyn, the England Students Manager and Cyprus Head Coach, to assist me and Andy award these caps.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to go off script a little bit to start with, and I'll wait for the scowl from Ben, but just firstly, a massive, massive thank you to Ben, Elaine and Saraya. They do a hell of a job, so thank you very much. As athletes, as players within the SU teams, you work incredibly hard. There's a certain number of people that probably work even harder and maybe don't get recognised every year, and that's the UOG staff. So if you'd like to be upstanding, I think they deserve one hell of a round of applause, so thank you. The University Cap is an incredibly prestigious award and is awarded to sports members who have competed at an international level while studying at the university. It is a credit to how our talent at university is growing, the number of caps which are handed out every year. I'd firstly like to invite to the stage our recapped individuals who have all previously received a University Cap, but would like to further recognise their achievement this year. They are Rebecca Trist, Megan Goddard, Sarah Nicholas, Devon Holt, Bianca Blackburn and Abby Parsons, all from women's rugby.
Let's go, make no excuses now, I'm talking here and now, I'm talking here and now. Let's go, your time is running out, I'm talking here and now, I'm talking here and now. It's not about what you've done, it's about what you do. It's all about where you going, no matter where you be. Let's go, go, let's go.
Just a little nod to women's rugby. Not many people get to win a Bucks title. Certainly very few get to win one twice. So to women's rugby, well done. The new international caps this year are Stephen Hartman, American football. Linda Lee, Kendo, Millie Wood, Women's Rugby, Abby Walker, Women's Rugby, Courtney Bishop, Women's Rugby, and James Gahan, Men's Rugby League and Union. All the best things in loving with a sister and a cousin, only started with a little kiss like this.
I estimated we'd be finishing these about 10 o'clock, so we're about 45 minutes above schedule. So we've got loads of time afterwards, so we'll leisurely go through these. I'd like to invite everyone's favourite mum and best person in the whole university, Elaine, back to the stage to present the Principal's Trophy for Athlete of the Year. Give it up for Elaine.
Standing in the Hall of Fame. And the world's gonna know your name. Cause you burn with the brightest flame. And the world's gonna know your name.
Thank you, everybody. Before I do carry on with this award, I do always like to say a little something to you, but today I've got a huge, massive thank you to say to you all that voted for me to win my award yesterday. It's something that I'll cherish forever and ever. But please, can I...
Elaine is prone to cry, so don't go too over the top.
But what I have to say is that I couldn't do my job, I couldn't enjoy my job, I couldn't love coming to work if it wasn't for all of you, and you are... Please take it with you. You're amazing people. Can you go again? And you helped me through so much as well. I do love you all. Thank you. Right, I'll compose myself again. I would just also like to say, just in case I don't get an opportunity again, I am also so lucky to work with the wonderful people in the SU, and particularly my subs, who I've got three of them here tonight. My current Ben, who's done an absolutely fantastic job. I've got James and Gary Mack as well, who was a sub of mine. We're very lucky to have the leaders that we do. Thank you. Right. Right. Each year there is a handful of people who stand out for their overall dedication to sport, whether it's at representative level or in Bucks competitions. These athletes show true professionalism when it comes to their sport and take their performance to the highest level. The nominations for this are... Bianca Blackburn, Women's Rugby. Becky Pritchard, women's rugby, athletics and American football. Ben Robinson, athletics. Kaney Cross, British champion. Jack Tootle, athletics. Nicole Talbot, weightlifting. This team member is a force to be reckoned with during competition, and although they have a terrifying presence off the field, we know deep down she's a bit of a softie. She's been an asset to the Women's Rugby Union team since joining the club, and her tenacity and dedication to training have resulted in her being selected for the England senior squad this year on many occasions. You all know now, this year's award goes to Bianca. Yeah!
I think we can agree, Bianca's a bit of a popular choice there. Thank you, Elaine. So I'd like to move on to the next award, and this is given for a team service to the community, charity, and for fundraising. And it'll be presented by the student union's favourite man, Kesh Patel.
Evening, everyone. Before I start, I sang a song last year. So if you'd like to join with me again this year, follow the lyrics. So, we are the... Thank you. Give yourself a round of applause. So, the next award is given for a team's service to community, charity, and fundraising. Firstly, I'd like to congratulate all the Students' Union teams for their amazing charity fundraising events. It makes us all proud to be associated with such giving teams. This year, our sports teams have raised over £10,000 for national and local charities, which is an astounding achievement, so well done. It is this selfless attitude that this year's sets these teams apart from the rest. Your nominees are as follows. American football for the Jarvis game. Cheerleading for cheering schools. Lacrosse for Lacrosse Community Scheme. Netball for Carly Taylor Week. Rowing for the Marathon Row. Men's Rugby Union for Muffin a China Shop charity game. Swimming and water polo for Splash of the Titans. And trampolining for Bounce-a-thon. So normally this award goes to the club that puts in the biggest or best fundraiser or puts in the most charitable work throughout the year. However, this year we are giving the award to one person. One person who has been committed throughout the year, delivering free community coaching sessions to over 120 13 to 15 year olds. They have done this completely off their own back without any award or recognition, purely to enhance the sporting offer for local children. He has been recognised for his hard work and dedication through national governing body and was also offered a job for his talent. This year's winner is Kel Monstad, Melton's Across. Okay, this says Elaine, I forgot to change it, but I'm actually doing this one, sorry. My bad, another mistake by me. So this award is for outstanding achievement. This is gonna be done a bit differently. You're gonna find out who it is very soon. I'm gonna ask the winners to stay in their seats because I've got a little bit of blurb to carry on about them. So the nominees are Athletics, smashing PBs and club records throughout the year. Women's rugby for their Bucks, 15s and 7s national champions. Men's rugby union first team for their Conference Cup finalists and league champions. Joby Wilson for Bucks karate gold medalist. And Tasha Lovell for Bucks shooting gold medalist. Okay, as I said, this will be done a bit differently. In previous years, this award has been presented to the individuals for their amazing sporting achievements throughout the year. But this year, it's been awarded to a whole team in honour of their hard work, dedication and success. Naturally, this year's award is given to Women's Rugby Union. Hold fire a second. Lauren, sit down. Okay, we've got a little bit of blurb about them. So, funny enough, women's rugby is one of our smallest teams in terms of members. I think it shows this is a case of truly quality over quantity. At the start of the season, the two triple-figure scores against Oxford and Chichester certainly got people's eyes opening to their capability. Could this be their year? The hype around them grew as they saw team after team with a close call, 12-10 victory over ex-league winners Uwick, aka Cardiff Met. As league winners, they kept climbing, seeing off Edinburgh and Exeter in the quarters and semis in spectacular form. In the latter half of these, saw a game-saving tackle made by Becky Pritchard. This was a truly heroic tackle, injuring herself to help secure the girls' place in the final. So I think we give her a big round of applause for that. And she unfortunately missed out on the final herself. The rest now has been made history. They have inspired a whole university as they proceeded to smash Cardiff and Cardiff Met at Twickenham in true style. They smashed everything we could have ever hoped of them. Then they went on to win the Bucks Sevens tournament, just to add a little bit of excitement to it. In about a month's time, they're off to the European finals. A magnificent year for an amazing team. I love you all to pieces. Please, can you give a warm round of applause to the women's rugby team who all join me on the stage, please.
I say small team? Okay, so I'd like to invite Exports Officer James Armar and Mr. Andy Deacon from Raging Bull to hand out this Raging Bull Sports Personality of the Year Award.
Just before we get started with the award, I'm going to let Andy do most of the talking because I'm pretty steaming. But I've just got to say, what an outstanding job Ben's done tonight, right? And he's not an event planner like that, but it's been a hell of a year. I know it has because I did it last year. And you have a lot of sleepless nights, a lot of very, very early mornings. But if you'd all join me in being upstanding, just for a round of applause for Ben. Andy's gestured me to do a little bit of speaking. So the next award to be presented is for the Sports Personality of the Year. This is given to the person that embodies the blue and blue spirit at the university all year round. There are so many students that have shown this over the course of the year, displayed by the sheer number and diversity of nominations received. This award is voted for by the club captains. The nominees are those that have received the most votes and are as followed. Alex Burnett Rowing. Emily Andrews, Women's Rugby. James Garn, Men's Rugby Union. Josh Shackleton, Rugby League. Lauren Chenoweth, and your next sports officer from Women's Rugby Union. And Linda Lee Kendo. James Hart, men's volleyball. My bad. Like I said, I'm steaming. And the winner is... This person is one of the biggest characters within EuroG. A happy-go-lucky person who takes on whatever life throws at them and keeps people motivated and entertained. The club captains have clearly acknowledged this person by voting in this personality. And the winner of the Raging Bull Sports Personality of the Year is Emily Andrews.
Okay, so we are running about an hour ahead of time. So we have three big awards left. We have the Team of the Year, the Club Captain of the Year, and the Club of the Year. All after, I'll give you a 10-minute break. Go get some beer in you and go get some pictures, have a drink. I'll see you back here in 10 minutes. We'll be right back. Okay then, guys, make your way back to seats, please. Include you, Cash. Okay then, just while everyone's sitting down then, I just sort of take a little opportunity just to let you guys know that anyone today that gets nominated, it's an incredible honour. And even if you don't get the win, we're recognising how amazing you are and how much you mean to University of Gloucestershire. So well done to all the people that have been nominated so far. Okay, so although it says Ben Parfitt on this speech, we're going to invite back the wonderful Elaine to present the Team of the Term Awards.
Don't believe me, just watch.
Add to what Ben said, you all do a fantastic job in whatever level sport you play. You're all brilliant. Many teams this year have put in some outstanding performances, illustrated by the astonishing seven teams nominated. When deciding the winner of this award, a criteria was met which took into account Bucks League standings, Bucks Cup competitions, national competitions and awards, along with the level at which the team's competing. This year's amazing eight nominees are cricket, cheerleading, women's football seconds, women's futsal first, men's rugby union firsts, women's rugby union, squash, women's volleyball firsts. An argument could be made for any of these teams this year, as all of them have been outstanding. However, this team have reached heights this year that UOG has only dreamed of before. This year's Team of the Year is
Thank you, Elaine, and congratulations, women's rugby. All right then, so we're getting into the big ones now. I'm going to invite Kate from Car Lane, who sponsored this award, to come up and help me assist.
Sing! as a blaze. I saw flames from the side of the stage and the fire brigade.
Right then, so this is the big one. So one of the most prestigious awards, thanks to Carlane who has sponsored this for us. It's very fitting as Kate is an ex-student here as well. So prestigious alumni still supporting this award. The responsibility and expectation thrust upon all club captains can be overwhelming. However, this year all have risen to the challenge and have given themselves up to their clubs whilst trying to balance their time needed for their own academic work. There is no prouder honour than putting in much time and effort into running of a club than to see it develop and progress throughout the year into a fantastic environment for your members to thrive in. The quality and dedication of our club captains makes this award near impossible to find that one that can just be named above all others. They've been assessed on the following: regular contact with the sports officer, regular attendance of club captain meetings, supportive of other club captains, responding well to emails, and most importantly, the vote of their fellow club captains. As ever, the outcome was incredibly close, but here are the final nominees. Ellie Carter, cheerleading. Lauren Shanaworth, women's rugby. Liam Sanford, athletics. Linda Lee, kendo. Lucy Walton, women's volleyball. Vicky Hatton, dance. And Vicky McGee from netball. The winner has far exceeded all expectations. Smashed every target I have given to them. Managing to turn a club with a £4,000 deficit last year into a £2,000 profit this year, and by far is one of the most humble people I have ever had the pleasure to meet. Your 2015 Carlane Club Captain of the Year is... Ellie Carter!
I feel good. I knew that I would not. I feel good. I knew that I would not. So good, so good. I got you. Oh, I feel nice. A sugar and spice. I feel. Sugar and spice.
Don't batter and bruise her too so much, nice. She's only small.
So nice, I got you. When I hold you in my arms, I know that I can't do no wrong. And when I hold you in my arms, my love. I feel nice, a sugar and spice. So nice, so nice.
Congratulations, Ellie, and thank you, Kate and Carlane. So, we have the final awards. And for this, I'd like to invite our Vice Chancellor, Stephen Marsden, to present the Ensley Club of the Year Awards.
Of kick starts again. Starts again. And the love kick starts again. Starts again.
There's just all this to read, so you can go through this. This and this. So just go through it. Okay. You can say your own words if you wish.
Okay.
To.
Good evening, everybody. Before announcing the winner of the Ensley Cup of the Year Award, this is the important bit. I would like to say congratulations to Ben Parfitt on this year's Sports Awards event. And also congratulations to Ben on his whole year as student union lead for sport. It's a difficult job, trying to keep you lot under control. He's done a fantastic job with huge enthusiasm, great professionalism, a lot of skill. He's never missed an opportunity to promote the many successes of the university sports team, and he's played an important role in developing sport across the university. He's been a pleasure to work with. Thank you, Ben. Turning to the Club of the Year award, many clubs have certainly impressed us this year with their organisation, support for each other, and their clear sense of unity and teamwork. The award is one of the most difficult to decide. We've used a number of criteria. First, whether they've achieved their membership quota. Second, how well they've done on their budgets. Third, whether they've sorted out adequate sponsorship. Fourth, how well they've supported other clubs. Fifth, how successful the teams have been. Sixth, how well the club has pulled together to deal with the issues which have arisen. Every club has its strengths, but six stood out, and the six are athletics, cheerleading, equestrian, men's rugby union, women's rugby union, and women's volleyball. And rowing, not here. This year's extremely deserving winner, drum roll please, last one of the evening, cheerleading.
Touch this. Look, man, can't touch this. You better get a hype, boy, cause you know you can't touch this. Ring the bell, school's back in. Break it down. Stop, have a time. Touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. Break it down.
Okay, so before we finish, there's a few thank yous. Before we finish. Okay, so well done cheerleading. Thank you very much, Stephen, for that award and that kind words. So I want to say a huge thank you to the university staff and coaching staff. Without their generosity and giving up their time to help out some of the clubs, we wouldn't have excelled in the same way they would have this year. So thank you to our university staff that are here. Especially Gary McLean, who's been dangling that carrot, keeping me going throughout the year. It's been fantastic, thank you. Thank you to the whole of the SU staff sat down here in front of me. They've been incredible throughout this year. from the finance team to commercial services, marketing, and to my fellow SABs. They've helped me in every way possible, just giving me a kick up the arse every so often, and really keeping me up when I've been down. So thank you so much. And the biggest thank you of all is to all of you guys in front of me. You've helped me make this year so special, and I'll be very, very sad to leave you all, but it's been an immense pleasure. Thank you so much. Big round of applause to you all. Sorry, I'm such a wuss. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. I really do. And thank you for making this night incredible. It's gone so smoothly, and I couldn't have asked for any better. A huge thank you to the sports committee, Liam, Ellie, Lauren, Sally, and Georgie. You've helped me through some tricky decisions this year, and you've been brilliant and professional throughout, so thank you. And finally, to my amazing sports team. They're ever close to my heart, and I'm so sad to leave you. I'm going to invite each one of you up, and I've got a little bit to say about all of you. So firstly, Lorea. She's awesome. She puts in so much hard work and has helped me massively this year. Her competitive nature has always rubbed off upon many of you guys this year as well, especially the women's rugby team. So thank you for her. If you'd like to come on up, Lorea. Secondly, Hope Fawcett, who's been my brilliant right-hand woman. She's always keeping me in check. She's been ace this year, and I'm sure she'll thoroughly succeed in her new position as community officer. I truly wish her the very best next year. Go on, Hope, come up. I'm slowly being surrounded by women. I get very put in my place in the office, put that way. Emily Court.
You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero.
Right, I didn't get a chance to say my little bit about Emily. But the much needed position of Vauxhall's receptionist was filled this year, miraculously by Minnie Elaine. Emily jumped through hoops for us this year, dynamically going above and beyond to help anyone and everyone. Along with her infectious charisma, in fact, she is always smiling. Myself and Lane definitely owe her a hell of a lot, and she's going to be amazing next year. And big one for hey, Emily. Finally. We do not condone that behaviour. And finally, the most popular person in this whole room, Elaine. Okay, so Elaine. Okay, so Elaine, you've been my rock. You well and truly deserved award last night at the Staff Awards, and I have no idea what I'm going to do with myself or UOG Sport would have to do if Elaine left, and I don't want to ever jinx that, touch wood. On a daily basis, you inject your passion into sport and these students. I'll always admire you and be indebted to you for all that you've done for me. And I'm sure that everyone in this room feels exactly the same. So I'd like to invite, I've done that bit, it's fine. We'll have a quick picture. After this, I want all the CCs up here and we'll have a group picture on the stage.